I said I'm Business Development Director. I'm based in Switzerland, so I'm a sales as well. So there are some sales somewhere. So yeah, I'm very proud to show you our very innovative smart enterprise solution for managing workspace and resources as well. So it's quite short, but yeah, I think should have just an overview about the solutions. And of course, as the other solutions, I have the solution installed. I have my colleagues here. So of course, we can present you and more in details the whole feature we have. Doesn't work? It's working? Trying? Yes, it's working. Thank you very much. So today, more and more enterprise rethought or are in process to rethinking their way, their workspace, their environment, the offices. And this has two main reasons. There are several reasons, but two main. The first one is, of course, depending on the sectors where we work, and especially in IT, it's not so easy to find qualified people, and having nice office and nice environment, it's one parameter which could help to acquire new employees. Of course. And the second way, when you acquire this employee, it's how to be first still attractive for them, keeping the motivation, and help as well creativity, help the collaboration between the people. So we see more and more such kind of open space, could be playgrounds, could be just open with some couches. So you just sit, you take your laptop, you just discuss with other guys. One of the famous company did that is, at least in Switzerland, in Zurich, you know, this the Google headquarter. It's very famous because they even have wine bars, I think, or kind of things going down from the floor, to play. So so this is really to today and the futures, these new offices. And of course, technology is as well central, how to book, how to control as well, and how to check how these different spaces are really used, because you don't want to put some kind of, let's call them a bit expensive infrastructure, if nobody is using that. So so technology is really important. I just got on that. Here are some figures to also show you how important it is. 35%, more than one third of the employees, some studies came. Would like to book resources through a mobile app, since so mobile is very important today. As well, from the facility management side, guys who are controlling different resources and offices, more than one third would like to use some kind of sensors to get some information about how this infrastructure is used. And yeah, just to one of the resources which is very important in a company is, of course, meeting rooms. Is some example, average hours per month of employees being in meetings, 30 hours. I'm sure some of you even pass these 30 hours per month. Anyway, today in the reality, before to thinking about this new open space and stuff, one resource, as I said, really important for everybody, and I'm sure you already met these kind of issues, this is for meeting rooms. So how to quickly and efficiently find the correct meeting rooms, the right infrastructure, not too big, not too small, is really an issue if you don't have solutions. So just using Outlook, majority using Outlook, doesn't give you a lot of information, and it's really kind of basic. So if you have several meeting rooms, you need to open that everything is parallel and so on. So this is the first issue, how to be efficient by booking the stuff. And even that on the mobility side, from everywhere, if you're on a train from home, you really want to quickly reserve something, you need to open your desktop, you need to open Outlook and stuff like that. So today it's quite difficult to book quickly, and it gives some frustration for people trying to find the right resource. When I speak here, I speak about resources. So meeting room is one of the main resources and main issue in the company, but not only. There are other common resources, like for example, carpools. You need to reserve a car, or you need to receive, I don't know, a Microsoft Surface Hub, which is quite expensive. You don't have that in all the meeting rooms. So there are a lot of different common resources, as we will see. But yes, focus is meeting rooms, where this is probably the biggest issue we know. The second part is, yes, you could book from everywhere the right, the correct meeting rooms, but as you probably also meet, that's the issue, is whether the meeting room is already occupied, or a lot of people just booked and don't go to the meeting rooms. So so I think this is also happening quite often. So yeah, this is, it has a cost. If you have a meeting room which is not used or not appropriately used, it takes space. There are expensive infrastructure inside and so on, so it has a cost. So you can use that for employees, for example, or you can move that. The third important point is, well, you need to get this information, how these different resources are used. If you don't have these informations, you cannot base decision to be more efficient, to plan your office new. So this is also very important, more for facility manager, this information. Right. So we have these solutions to really help reducing all these different issues, and it's workable. I think Jürgen said already, what does it mean? We repeat, so it nothing to do with Haribo, the gummy candy, nothing. So just workable is work in better office. It's starting with, I said meeting room, so the name we changed. It was just really meeting room focus, and we enlarged that more and more with other resources. So it didn't make sense anymore to call it meeting room. Still, it's still the focus, since it's still, as I said, the main issue. But I will see it's quite bright. And yes, the three issue I was explaining just before, we try to solve that. So how to book easily, quickly from everywhere, and in an intuitive way. This is also very important. Managing, there's a lot of different functionality to around meeting and resources. Just an example, catering, I will show you later. Adding a room for a participant for another location and stuff like that. And yes, finally the reporting, which is saying how important it is. I will start with the base, so showing a bit the concept of the solution. So the first, as we say, we speak about, I don't know, the laser, how it's working, perhaps it doesn't work. We speak about meeting room and other resources, some example, carpools, parking slots, and other stuff. And we have two ways to actually book these different resources. First one is, and very important, is the mobile application, iOS, Android. So you can really book everywhere. It's not only, you will see later, taking a look at the resources, but really do the invitation with all details behind. And the second one is a plugin for Outlook. We didn't do a separate desktop because everybody using, not everybody, but the majority use Outlook. So actually we want to add the value to Outlook. So when somebody needs a room or other resource, then he can just open the plugin and choose the stuff. We'll show as well some screen later. I started by the mobile. The mobile is really central in the application and in this solution. And this is also our differentiations to some of solution existing, which are very old school or using mobile just for showing the available resource, but that's it, cannot really go forward. So with the application, it's really intuitive. So in a one view, you really see an overview about all the meeting rooms for the location you selected. And then you see for the next 8 hours, really in one view, with the infrastructure, with the capabilities and so on. Then you can really go inside and click inside and have different information. Cannot do, as I said, live demo, but it will be nice to for you if you're interested to see that. There's really a lot of different stuff you can do, and very easily you can see the map, you can see the room where it is located, you can see, you can add, as I said, catering directly there. You can say, hey, I want a certain meal, I want something like that. You can add the specifics. Sometimes you have room, you can move the wall, you can move the infrastructure inside, you can predefine a certain arrangement, and there inside as well, giving this information, and so on. And do a really a complete booking with really added values. And the important as well is for security reason, for the performance reason, we still use Exchange as a central booking, so the data remain in Exchange. So let's imagine our servers will explode. You can still actually, with a really limited functionality, continue your booking. So the data is still staying in Exchange, whether in Exchange on-premise or Office 365, which is more and more, of course, used for that, right? So, it has different help, like as well if you try to invite people directly and they have conflict, they really have meetings, so that the application will show you, hey guys, be careful, this there is a conflict there, or if they are outside the time zone, another location, you have warning, and also the solution will give you as well, give you sometimes, propose you sometimes when everybody and the room will be available, so you can just click, take over this date and click. So there is a lot of kind of support like that. And I said it's not only meeting room, so it's the same principle and it's quite a flexible. Here we have some kind of example for cars, parkings, bikes. A lot of countries now, a lot of companies, you can rent an electrical bike and stuff like that, trying to be ecologic, as you can see here. And it's the same principle. You can link that to meetings. That means if you need a bike or a parking slot for a meeting and the meeting is cancelled, of course, it's then automatically released the parking slot because you don't need anymore if you want to link that, and kind of featuring like that. For parking as well, that could be you could get a code, a barcode on your app to be able to enter a parking with a barrier to open that. So this is kind of feature we can propose. And then of course not everybody is mobile, even if it's really central today, mobile. So you have to have the possibility to use that on a desktop. This is just some screenshot for the plugin, an extended plugin, but this is coming into the Outlook client to be able to really directly do the same with Outlook. And also for biggest company having many locations somewhere, you can do meetings same time for different locations, so for webinar and stuff like that, when you need different resources, you can do that like that. So it's really appreciated for big companies. So also one important component in this solution, we use sensor, eBeacon sensors, that we can place to meeting rooms. So this is, remember the second part, once somebody is booking but not using the resource. So is this to checking that's really that you have really somebody inside. So actually we use the mobile, the intelligence is on the mobile part. So the mobile part, when you're moving with your mobile, the mobile application will get some identification beacon and it will give this information to the server. So they will know, Gabriel Indino, he's going to these rooms. What did he do? Did he already book or he didn't book? Perhaps he need a meeting rooms and so on and so on. Okay, so this is checked to have different interaction. Very quickly, some interaction we can do with that, thanks to this principle about mobile and sensors. Typical, I said auto-check-in, that means you book a room, you come to the room, it's just confirming you're using the room. If you don't do that, for example, you will get some notification, hey, you book a room as organizer, you are not in, So do you want to keep that? After a certain different level, if you don't answer, then the system will decide, okay, let's release that. Well, for other people. There is also, when you're doing a meeting, you book for 2 hours, but you leave after 1 hour. So actually, the rest of the time, you should release the meeting automatically. So you have the same. You're leaving the room, and the system will ask you, hey, do you still need the room? Because perhaps you're just going to get a coffee. So you need to keep the room. So this is one, or opposite. You book for 1 hour, but you need a bit more. So if 5 minutes before the end, for example, you get a notification, say, hey, you're still in the room. Do you want to extend? It's just one click. So you don't need to open Outlook. You don't need to open stuff. With just one click, you can just extend the meeting. So there are different actions and intelligence knowing who is where and do this. Then there is a part, digital signage part. This is actually the famous component we saw in some of the companies. This is first the front the tablet in the front of the meeting rooms, giving some information about the meetings, and also some central display, some content on the smart TV you can install everywhere to just show you, for example, the map and other information about the resources. This is digital part. There's quite a lot of software having just this kind of software on the tablet, but of course not doing smart interaction, not having the mobile app, etc. But this is quite famous, there's quite a lot. And this is kind of what we show on the screen. So on this screen, we could also check in manually without mobile. You just check your name. You can book directly. You can see the map. You can book for another room. If you go and it's busy, you can go and try to see where you have another room. So it is also useful for that. And this is kind of central display you could install in the lobby. So when you are entering the building and you need meetings, then you can see in one view where is the meeting, and you have some picture as well, you can recognize where it is and so on. This is mainly a web view, which is actually accessible from any part, from a PC, for an employee, just taking a look about, I want to have a meeting as well, I go through this interface. Don't know how many times I have. Nothing. Okay, 2 minutes. Ah, it's fine. 2 minutes. And there is quite a new model, which is the visitor management. So when you are inviting people, there are, of course, sometimes a client, external people. And this is my own experience as a sales guy, going to a lot of companies, and they don't know where you are, with who you have to have a meeting and so on. So this is, thanks to this kind of components, you are already registered by the organizer. So when you arrive in a company, you just give your name, and they know with whom you have to meet, when, and they can even print your badge directly, and you don't have to write yourself. And when she can do a check-in, she say, oh, this client is in the building, it will send us a notification automatically to the organizer, so you don't, the secretary doesn't need to try to find the organizer. So automatically, hey, Gabriel is in the building, okay, I'm going. So there are a lot of things like that, and yes, also security reasons, so you know who is in the building or who left the building and stuff like that. So there is different view on that. This is the view for visitor management. So you have a list, so the secretary, the receptionist can really prepare every morning, can see the list, can know exactly who is coming and really be prepared. It's a good image as well for customers coming from externally. I think it's quite important. Yes, and the rest is the admin and report part. Thank you for my colleague who explained actually how Kibana is working, because it's working with Kibana. It was an example for other industry. This is also another example. So we have predefined about 20 parameters, whether graphic or a number of minutes that the system decided to saved when decided to release the runes. So, but of course, you can add, every customer can add new information, new graphic with data, right? And yes, that's it. So I think I'm quite good with the time. I would like as well to thank, we have several partners. One in Switzerland is Swisscom, which is reselling the solution, but we have as well one in France, really close to the digital signage market. So I would like to thank as well LCS, our French partner, to be here in Cluj during the event. I don't see them. I don't know if they're... Ah, there they are. Good. So thank you for them. And yeah, I don't know if you have questions. Yes.
Thanks. So thanks for addressing this topic, first of all, because I think it's, at least for my environment, a very painful experience to book meeting rooms. I'm more interested, as you talk smart, how smart is the calendar integration, for example, into Outlook or Google or whatever we use?
Yeah.
So what kind of added value do I have? What experience do I get?
Yeah, for just an example, I was discussing when you book for 2 hours a room and you leave the room, for example, after 1 hour. So after 1 hour, typically what's happened? So you all have Skype also for chatting. So what's happened? You see a lot of times colleagues being in meetings. And actually, when you are in a meeting and you go back to the office, nobody is changing manually the profile. So this will release the room as well. So that means you will have in the calendar the duration and as well the participants. So the all participants, and we are a common resource for the company. So we will be then available automatically without changing the time. That's one thing. But generally about that value, this is the maps, this is infrastructure, this is all this kind of value, and of course, one view. In one view, you see all the room available. Quite a lot of advantage on that, bringing in comparison to Outlook, and we can show you live if you want things. Another one is recurring meetings, which is quite well used, and this is really difficult in terms of project 6 months, 1 year, to find the right free room. With our system, you automatically know for the whole period you have the free room.
Thanks. Are you, to be more specific, are you making use of, I would call it, contextual information out of your calendar? So for example, I want to set up a meeting with 4 people. So I'm already setting up the meeting in my calendar with 4 people.
Yeah.
The system or my calendar knows where my office is. The calendar knows typically where the people sit that I invited. So I would expect a smart solution. If I say I need a meeting room, it knows I need a meeting room for 5 people in Mannheim, in this and that building, instead of me entering again through nice filters, again saying I need a meeting room for 4 people, I need it in Mannheim. So is that?
It's not yet so far, but this is, yes, this is in our goal to be even more smart in this way. And this information is available, so it's just a question about how the decision, can we take a generic decision, because then you could perhaps customize, but yes, this is definitely a direction where we go. Product manager Lucci, perhaps he can say more.
Some of those problems get solved through other means. Know your location. So the system knows your location. So for instance, it's gonna put you in the building you are in already. So when you enter the building, there's a beacon. If you are next to a meeting room, there's a beacon. So they are context aware. And of course, you have favorite rooms, so it's going to show you the first room that if you have a room that you keep booking in. Also, when you book a room where the people don't fit, there are too many people coming, then it's going to give you a warning. It's going to first propose a room that fits your number of people and not too much more, so you don't take up space you don't need. So there are things built in there. The kind of intelligence you mentioned, yes, it is in our roadmap, but honestly, it's kind of well solved already if you try the system. So it's you need to give it a try.
It's worth it to really see on the added value on that, so to try that.
Thanks again.
Well.
One moment, please.
Sorry? Yeah, we have 2 different prices models. One is a purchasing licenses, and the other one is subscription licenses. So depending which kind of enterprise, we cannot choose whether one or the other one, and we are enough flexible to be able to go in this model. But I think pay as you grow subscription model will be more and more required.
Per building or per plot?
Per user.
Yeah.
Which is quite new, because a lot of kind of old school were more about resources, but then it's clearly, our application is clearly user-centric. So it's really the user having different possibility, and not only meeting room and stuff, but also broader resources. Welcome.